All right, so we want you to hear you and your testimonies. Who's coming up first? Others, I am going to call you up, okay? Who's coming up first to share what God has done through these days of retreat at the New Creation Home? Who's first? Your name?
My name is Sunita.
Sunita. All right.
Sorry for the voice. This is the jam session talking, yesterday's jam session, where I was screaming at the top of my voice, praising God.
Sunita, where are you from?
I am from Goa. I am from Goa, from Salvador Dumund, a village roundabout in Porvorim. Have you all heard of Salvador Dumund? Okay. You know, Goans are here, right? Goans? Any Goans here? No Goans, man. Ah, okay, fine. How this retreat benefited me? I came here for this retreat alone. Mama asked me, Baba, no friends are coming? I'm like, Mama, no. Why? No one wants to come, like. I'm like, okay, fine, you told anyone? Yeah, I told. I took it in a positive way. I'm like, it'll help me to pray. You know, I'll be able to focus more. Okay, fine. I came here first day. It was a lovely session. I reached late, though. I had something caught up. Anyway, I reached for the first day, got a lovely message about overcoming worry. A lovely praise and worship session. The Acoustic Project came, and it was lovely to praise God with them. Then, second day, another lovely message of how you overcome temptation. Then the praise and worship session, and then I was back in my dormitory, and I was like, what am I doing here? I was bored. I had nobody to talk to. I was alone. I was like, why in the world did I come alone? I was getting all abus. Does any Goan know what is the meaning of abus? Yes, I was getting abus. I'm going mad. I'm going alone. Fine, the word of God is there, but I don't know whom to share the word of God with. Then, on the third day, I'm like, God, please give me something. I'm feeling really abus. I really don't know what to do with your word. Then, during the praise and worship, the song came, Be Still. I'm like, okay, fine. I'll be still. Maybe God wants me sometimes to shut up and to meditate on the word that is being taught, to be still, let it sink in you. And then it will have an effect at the right time, which did happen. As I was going through, I'm chatting with my friends on WhatsApp, I'm telling them there's a nice retreat I'm attending, and they're like, pray for us. Sister Sini, that's what they call me, because I don't know why, they just call me Sister Sini. And I wanted a friend. I was just not getting a friend. I'm trying to talk. But you see, I'm not a girl who doesn't go somewhere and does not have a friend. I always have a friend wherever I go. I'm come to this youth retreat, I cannot open my mouth. I'm like, Mama, I'm shy. What? Shy? Since when did that word enter your vocabulary? I'm like, Mama, I don't know. Maybe God just wants me to shut up again. I'm like, okay, fine. But I took the courage and I started talking to this one small girl. Her name is Karen. And she's in the 8th standard. I'm like, hi. She's like, hi. Fine. Later on, I'm waiting for the Lord. But then I'm like, okay, fine. I'll just seek God's word first. Seek it first, the kingdom of God. I'm like, fine. And his righteousness, fine. And all these things shall be given unto you. I'm waiting for that. Okay. I'm seeking the word. And then I'm calm. I'm like, okay, fine. In the afternoon, all of a sudden, Karen comes and stands in front of me. Jam session, you're going, no? Like, yeah, coming. Like, okay, fine. Yesterday we came and we danced like crazy people, like crazy praising God, like crazy in front. I don't know who has seen us or what, but we were screaming at the top of my voice. You can hear my voice is gone completely. And I was really happy with what happened. I accepted Jesus like never before. I was a VGC, a very good Catholic, okay? But I witnessed this lovely relationship with Jesus. It really made me feel lovely. It's just not the feeling. There's more to feeling than this. I really don't know how. I know that after this, it's going to be a lovely experience at the moment I step outside a New Creation Center. I just completed my master's in Mangalore. Any Mangaloreans out here? No Mangaloreans also. There was this big population of Mangalore colors over there. Okay, fine. I was in Mangalore, St. Aloysius College. I was studying there. I just finished my master's and I came. I was so happy that I'm coming for this new creation center. I've been waiting for this ever since youth retreats have started. Because every time the youth retreats were there, I used to be in Mangalore studying. I would never get this opportunity. I finished my master's and I came. I'm like, I saw the email youth retreat and I came. And when I came here, I'm glad that I came here. I don't know how many of y'all will agree that y'all are glad. Does anyone agree that y'all are glad that y'all have come for this retreat? Anybody? Anybody? Nobody, right? I want to hear if y'all are really happy that y'all have come for this retreat and accepted Jesus in your life. People! I think y'all can do much better than that. Please. Can y'all do much better than that? Are y'all happy that y'all have a lovely relationship with Christ? Okay, I can hear something better now. Thank you. So, whatever happens, I know it'll be tough. It'll definitely be tough the moment I step outside over here and say, I love Jesus. Devil will try his utter best, to say no. You know what, devil, you can go ahead and maybe I can keep Jesus a little bit behind, you know, you can have your way. I'm going to try my level best with God's help to put Jesus first and then let the devil watch the show.
Come on, let's give the Lord a big hand. Come on for this.
I'm sure everyone over here.
So just tell me one thing, just if you have to sum this whole retreat up in one word.
Yeah.
Just one word, what would that be?
Okay, I'll just keep this simple.
Just one word.
Okay. Awesome.
Awesome. Okay. Awesome. The Lord is awesome. Thank you so much. I believe she's a wonderful MC. And keep in touch with us. Maybe the next youth retreat, we'll be giving her the mic. Because the way she carries herself and presents herself on stage, awesome. Good show. Wonderful. Okay, come on. Beautiful. I like your stage presence. I like your pitch. And take over my job. Come on. All right. Anyone else? Come on, come on, come on, run. We just got a few moments. Please be considerate. We have very limited time. We'd like to hear a lot of you guys. Just 2 minutes, okay? Girl, are you listening to me? Your name, where are you from?
Valerie, Goa.
Okay, Goa? 2 minutes. Time Goa. Starts now.
You make some noise, Goans. Lovely. 2 minutes is the time slot. I'll finish it. Trust me, you're not going to enjoy it. The second day, first day of the retreat, regular retreat, singing, dancing, regular my style. Second day of the retreat, I was a bit disturbed. Everyone were like crying the previous day, experiencing everything of God, and I'm like, what rubbish, God not listening to me. I'm not experiencing that peace. I'm not experiencing that, I can say that love. I knew He loves me. I know He loves me. He loves me like Lord. But I'm not experiencing, I'm not feeling it. It's like not hitting me right. And I was that day, Brother Johnson was teaching about how you can get offended and how you shouldn't take offense. And I don't know, I went to give blood donation. I came and just a split of a second, something happened and something reminded me of something in the past. I was all furious and angry for what? I have no idea. Then I after the session was like almost over, I went to Brother Alred and told him like, see, I'm really irritated. I don't know what to do. Give me some solution. I'm really pissed off. He told me, just go open your prayer booklet and read concerning worry and fear and give me a message at the end of the day, whether you read it, how many times? And he told me 40 times. Times, I said, not read even 5 times properly, 40 times. Okay, I said, I'll do it. I read it, I made an attempt to read it. I read maximum 10 times. I read it, but later on in the evening, Yeshua band was playing. When Yeshua was playing, they put us into beautiful worship, and you know, they made us think over things, and they called the Holy Spirit, and they were like, wow, hats off. They were like,
that was Saturday night, right?
That was
Friday night.
Friday night.
Wow. Yeah.
I'm telling you, Friday night. And then later on, I was not at a point concentrating there also. I was feeling very sleepy because like the music was so beautiful, just go to sleep. All of a sudden, Cameron announced that anyone who wants to like stand, sit, do whatever you all want, just feel yourself in God's presence. Me, from all other people, thought of kneeling down. I don't kneel, and I can't kneel. One reason being, I have a ligament tear in my back, lower back, and I can't kneel for more than 5 minutes because of my weight and lots of other stuff. As I don't know why I kneel, forget. And I was just concentrating, and all of a sudden, I feel this excruciating pain in my back. It was like when you're bleeding, you have a wound in you, someone just keeps their hand and squeezes that hand. And yeah, it was like that. And within 2 seconds, it was gone. And I actually, kneeling, I'm checking, what is it? God touched me and He healed me of my back pain. A little more info about it. I've been suffering for this for 2 years and it has been like a part of my body only. I know that every time I dance, every time I wear heels, I come home and firstly take medicine saying, okay, it's going to pain. I'm taking the medicine, chalo. And He touched me, and then after that, I was like so crazy. I don't know what I danced. I don't give a damn what happened. I'm just dancing. So the God touched me there. Praise God. He's awesome. Trust me. The second thing what happened to me today itself, when everyone was asking for the gift of tongues, I have my gift of tongues. And I said, like, everyone's going on praying and helping each other get the gift of tongues. And I was with my saying, doing my gift of tongues, calling out to God and this and that. And I'm like, should I go, God? All of a sudden, I hear a voice. What are you able to do? Don't you think also you're not going to, now you'll simply fall in shame. I realized it was the voice of the evil one, and I said, you idiot, get out, don't talk to me, I'm going to go now. And trust me, I went. The first person I got started crying in my arms, and I was like, God had a plan for me. This evil one was not allowing me to go. And it continued, and I realized it, that you should always listen to the devil. Turn it the opposite, you'll get your answer right. To summarize this retreat in one word, amazing grace.
Wow, that's two words, but we get it. It's been awesome. Thank you. You've been a wonderful sharer. And a lot of people to replace, Brother Johnson, Alred, myself, etc. Wonderful, wonderful, amazing. Your name?
Tanya, and after 2 Goans, 1 Mangalorean. So, praise the Lord. Okay, so...
Come on, shout out, praise the Lord. Come on, people.
After lunch, brother. After lunch, it's always... Yeah, okay, anyway. So, many of us this time came for the first time. So, I speak for all the people who came for the first time here. We didn't really know what to expect. Either we were here because someone dragged us. We were here because someone told us it is good. We were here because something happened. And we never believed that Jesus was calling us till we actually reached here. We came here, we reached here, we didn't know what to expect. Praise and worship, word of God, it happens all the time. And I don't know when and where it must have touched you, but I'm sure it has. For all those who love Jesus and did not know the way to reach to Him, how to get to there, Brother Johnson has broken it up and given us, you know, Cadillac feeding, as in step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5, Jesus. So literally, you get to know what you're supposed to do to reach Jesus. And if not today, if not tomorrow, I'm sure you will definitely follow those and reach Jesus and come back and give testimony. So right now, my testimony is not there, but break your bath afterwards for the next movie, I will come back and I will give my testimony. Praise the Lord.
Wow, amazing.
And today for the anointing that was happening, I always have this wrong conception that only selected blessed people, few people have the anointing. And today I was so stubborn that until and unless, Lord, you personally come and give me my anointing, I'm not leaving this place. So I got my anointing and I got it so much that literally I am a new creation. So now I understand why this place is called New Creation Home. Because when you leave from here, you are not the same person that came here. Praise the Lord.
Woohoo! Praise the Lord. But you have to sum it up in one word, girl. Come back. Put the skids on. One word.
Jesus, because Jesus is amazing. Jesus is awesome. Jesus is everything. Jesus.
All right. And you don't have a wristband on. You better collect one from Nicole. Nicole is there, I think, in one of those bags there. Okay. Your name.
Hello. My name is Sheena. I'm from Goa. And, you know, many times I tried to come for the youth retreat, but I always got to come on Sundays because this is my 12th standard, and like it's very difficult. We have tuitions and a lot of studying and all. So I have many problems in my life, like one big problem is that first time in my life I'm ever studying so much with a lot of determination. But then I used to get many distractions and all. How much ever I should try, like, Jesus help me and all. But then worry used to come, like, I can't do it and all. But then my brother Johnson taught us that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. My God Himself has anointed me. So, like, I keep on thinking whenever fear comes towards me, I keep on thinking about that and I'm like, yes, I can do it, like. And Brother Johnson said, like, if you become, you shouldn't give in to the devil. Like, I was getting a lot of cold and I used to get headaches and then my eyes were specs also. But I said, devil, I'm not going to listen to you. I am healed by the name of Jesus. So today I'm in front of you without specs. And like,
wow, amazing. Come on, give the Lord a shout of praise. Woo! It's amazing.
My sinus has also disappeared. I had sinus problems for 1 year. And I'm a person who can't talk to a person. Like, I have phobia talking to people. I had phobia talking to people. I can never talk on the stage. And I can dance like that, but I can't face people. Before talking to someone, I have to make up my mind what I have to talk. And even after making up my mind, I just can't talk, like. And I really loved the session of the tongues. So, because I actually got to, I had a focus in my life. Like, I tried to get the Holy Spirit and I got it also. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you.
So, she's been healed of her eyesight problem. She's been healed of sinus. She's been healed of phobias. Praise the Lord. Come on, can you give the Lord a shout of praise? And if you have to sum up this retreat in one word, what would that be?
It's amazing.
Amazing. All right, so the retreat was amazing for her. That's for you. God bless you. Anyone else? Come on. Yeah, I was just wondering what's happened to the guys. What's happened to the guys? Where have they gone? Your name, bro.
Hello. The truth of mine is because I was shouting a lot in this 3-4 days. Okay, so my name is Hector Crasto. I'm coming from Goa, from Kolem. And what I'm here, this 3 days, what happened to me was, it was been a great success in my life. Whatever Brother Johnson has taught me is something which has really touched my life. And I know the doubts, whatever doubts I had during my life, and whatever doubts I had in my faith, okay, it's all cleared up through him. So I thank Brother Johnson for all the preaching that he has done and whatever things that affected me. I know what it is. And I also thank Vanessa's mom. If Vanessa's mom is looking right now on the TV, I thank you, Auntie, for telling me about this place and telling me about Brother Johnson, because she sat with me for 1 hour and she was just talking to me and telling me how this place is about and how what Brother Johnson preaches. I've been to many retreats all over India and also in other parts of the world. So it's like, it was very different, this retreat, and it was very different from many others, because others, they preach about, you know, evil spirits and bondages and curses and a lot of other things. But over here, Brother Johnson was speaking about faith, about how to, you know, how to be strong, how to be courageous, how to fight the devil, the thing which is there most important in my life. So through his preaching, through his teachings, and mostly the praise and worship over here, the praise and worship was superb, fantastic. It was like something really youthful. Otherwise it's like, you know, you just sing to God and all that. But you know, with dancing and jumping, and you really feel that youthful spirit coming to us. So that's what I liked about.
Do you agree with him? Do you agree with him?
Okay. So thank you for that. And I thank you for this retreat center for giving us this retreat center in Goa especially. I was thinking, like, you know, where is the retreat center in Goa? Because I'm from Goa, I didn't know about this place. But it's only through Vanessa's mom, which I thank her for that I found this retreat center over here in Goa. Otherwise I go to other places, other states, you know the places which are there, right? in other states, like in Kerala and Bombay. So I know these places, but they are in Goa. I didn't know the Heritage Center was over here. So the thing is, I thank all of y'all, even brother and Brother Johnson especially. And may God bless him, and may his retreat center work fruitfully, and more people come to know about this space. And surely I'll be the one who's telling the people there's a retreat center here in Goa. Okay, so thank you everyone. And also one more thing, I like to do this thing. This thing is, so I want you all to repeat after me, okay? It's a big shout to the Lord. It's a big shout to the Lord. I want all the demons and the evil spirits to get out from here. And for this place to be holy and this place to be blessed by the Holy Spirit. So that thousands and thousands of people, especially in Goa, to come over to this retreat center and make the best use of this place. Okay? So I want all of you to shout after me. Okay? It's Hallelujah! I'm done.
No. Get off your seats. Get onto your feet. This is a victory shout. This is a victory cry. And truly, 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 bondages have flown and demons have flown and sicknesses and disease have got out of this place. You have to give the Lord a better shout. Come on. Once again, help him with his voice. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Go!
Hallelujah!
Come on, give the Lord a shout of praise. Come on.
Hallelujah. One more. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Give the Lord a big clap of praise. God bless you, bro. And I really appreciate what he said. He said, I've been to many retreat centers. I've been to many retreats. But this retreat center is different. This retreat center is special. And those of you who are here and agree with that, please go and tell several others that so that many more can come and be blessed. Will you do that? Okay, come on. We have time for a few more. Can you just run up and come quickly so that we can give God the glory? Come quickly. Just a few more testimonies. Come. Who's coming next? Come. Just a few more. Surely the Lord has done something more and marvelous in your life that you would want to share. Come. Quickly. Okay, my favorite friend. After her, you. Okay. Oh, so for the youngest one, she deserves a gift. Carry on and I'll give you your gift. Your name?
My name is Valian from Mumbai.
Mumbai. Come on, give the Mumbai Indian a big clap.
The first day when I come, I was very scared of hens. I had hen phobia. After I listening Brother Johnson's preaching, and I have asked Brother Johnson for how should I get stop getting scared of hens. Brother Johnson told me to read 2 Timothy 1:7, and after that I read it 2-3 times, and after that I'm cured of I don't get scared anymore of hens. I thank you, God, for Brother Johnson for helping me to come out from the phobia of hens. Thank
you. Wow. Praise the Lord. Come on. Give the Lord a shout of praise. And this is for you, sweetie, for coming up so boldly. That's a beautiful song. Songbook, 550 songs with chords. And the Yeshua new CD. She deserves it. Don't you agree? Come on. Time for just 2 more testimonies. Anyone? Oops, here comes Angel. All right, Angel and her friends. Come on, let's hear it from you guys.
We did not know the gift of tongues. But now while we have come here, we know the gift of tongues. Praise the Lord.
Give the Lord a shout of praise. Come on. They have received the gift of tongues. Give the Lord a shout of praise. Come on. Angel, I know you. And what's your name?
Abigail.
Abigail. And yours?
Andrea.
Y'all are both sisters?
Yes.
Oh, y'all look And y'all are cousins. Okay, come on. Friends and sisters and cousins. One second. Y'all enter. So most of you enter the new creation home as strangers. But y'all leave as friends. Okay? Y'all are our friends now. And there's a divine connection. It can be, give the Lord a clap of praise for those divine connections. And this is a CD for Angel and for her cousins, for coming up so boldly and beautifully and giving God the glory. As a family, y'all can share that, right? Okay, give the Lord a clap of praise. Come on. Time for just one more. All right, here comes our brother. Come on, let's encourage him with a clap. Come on. You can be in touch with us. You can be in touch with us at the websites that the email address that will be put up on the screen shortly. That email address, you can send us your confidential feedback, your suggestions, your opinion, your critical, constructive criticisms. Please do that so that ultimately we will continue to be a blessing. It's newcreationyouth@goa.gmail.com. newcreationyouth@gmail.com. Make a note of that. How many of you, like I asked you before, are on the media sites like Twitter, Facebook, etc., etc.? Well, we are all on Facebook. Brother Johnson's on Facebook. I'm on Facebook. So Yeshua Band's on Facebook. The Acoustic Project's on Facebook. Connect and let's continue to network and win many more souls for the kingdom. Yeah. Maybe just one more testimony after our brother here.
Check. Praise the Lord. My name is Clifford Bennett. I'm originally from Goa, but I live just across the border in a place called Belgaum. Last month I attended a one-day retreat of Brother Johnson's in Bangalore, and I was really touched by his talks. So this time I made it for the youth retreat along with my family, my wife and three children. I've been following them a lot on Facebook and other media. Now, to tell you a little miracle which took place, how I landed here. If you could see my deformity, it's not a disease or something. It's the negligence of some doctors. They operated on my leg and destroyed my liver and kidney with a lot of antibiotics. So I'm fighting that for the last 1.5 year. So please pray for me. Okay? The next is, we were traveling the other day from Belgaum to Goa, and halfway, say after crossing 50 kilometers, I was feeling very uneasy and I wanted to go back and get admitted in the hospital. Because every time, every 10 days, we pump out about 8 to 10 liters of water from my stomach. It's excess water. So I told the driver, turn the car, we are going back and we'll travel the next morning. But that thing didn't happen because in the car was Brother Johnson's CD playing, and there was a song which was playing, Holy Spirit. What was it, Rana? My Holy Spirit is upon you.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon you, and God Himself has anointed you.
I said, whatever may happen, I told the driver, turn the car back, and that's how we landed back here. And I attended all the 4 days of retreat. A little bit to tell you about, I've been to about 15 to 20 retreats all over India, but there's no such place like this masterpiece which has been built anywhere in India for the retreats I've been to. The place is awesome. The talks by Brother Johnson are very touching and very informative, to the point. It really gives you a lot of knowledge. So I just want everyone to follow the white booklet and the CD. The CD, since I grabbed it, I've been playing it for 12 to 14 hours a day, non-stop at home on my laptop. And every night I follow them on live streaming on internet. So this is a nice new address in town. So whenever we want to come for a short break to Goa, so we know now this is a new place. And to sum it up in one word, I'll tell you, this is God's creation. The creative home is God's creation.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Brother. Hallelujah. So I like that statement. He's been for several retreats all across the nation, but he finds tremendous presence of God at New Creation Home, and we give God the glory for that. Amen. So you got family here, friends. You've got family here, so feel free to come here anytime you wish in to enjoy God's presence and to grow in the strength of the Lord. Your name?
Hello everyone. My name is Suman.
Suman.
I am from West Bengal. I stay at Bangalore. I'm working there. I am from a family, it's a Hindu family. And suddenly what happened to me, like from a Hindu family, a guy who started believing into Jesus, I am so much fond of my God, Goddess is there. I mean, I was a guy like, I cannot leave my God. Oh my God. Like every time I used to chant my God, Goddess is there. But at some point of time, I feel like, no, this is like, you know, the reason that I came into Jesus, I want to bow my head down to the Jesus is because, like, you know, I was not finding a community. I was not finding a friends, sisters, brothers there who will love me, who will accept me. My father is a political leader at Bengal. His duty was to serve society. He did many things for the society. My mom was a supervisor of a school, so his duty was to serve kids, the health, the education, everything. So even that nature is in my DNA, in my blood. I do the same exactly in Bangalore. I try to help kids. I have a Facebook group where I'm helping like orphans, and I have a group, cancer awareness group. I'm trying to help cancer patients around India, trying to connect top doctors, and through the word of God, right now I'm like, you know, not I, we are teaching the cancer patients. Sister Jocelyn, Madonna, they are helping. So I was looking for a community where I can channelize my potential that is a gift from my mom and dad. So it's a God's bless. I would say it's a Hindu God, Goddesses. They told, no, Suman, this is not a right field for you. You go to Jesus. This is a right field that you are a seed. You can be a big tree. So that is why I think I came to Jesus, and I'll be keep loving Jesus, keep loving Jesus, and keep loving Jesus. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Suman. And Suman is very, very interested in learning more of God's word. And can you just stretch your hands out towards him as we pray? Father, I thank you for the cloud of glory that is upon Suman, upon his whole family, upon his whole village in West Bengal. And wherever he goes, God, I thank you that you are giving him that land. Thank you, God, that you are enabling him to be bold and courageous. And that, Lord, all the blessings of your kingdom is upon him, and he will share that with many, many souls in Jesus' name. Amen. Suman, this is for you.
Yeah, thank you.
With all our love, and
keep
in touch.
Thank you so much. Just one more, like, I want to do a Bengali namaskar. Like, we do it like this. Thank you so much, everybody.
So that's our Bengali namaskar. Come on, guys.
Thank you.
Once again, Suman, can we see that?
Love for everybody.
Can we see that once again?
This is like, you know, like this. Like this. I mean, wow. We just do like this. Bengali namaskar.
That's beautiful. Hallelujah. Thank you, Suman. Can you just hand over the mic to the family? Auntie, could you give us your name?
Mojano Anchasam Fernandez. Uncle Waliji. Maha Thor Boren Sanatle. Thor Boren and Report and Maja Duktale. इतलें दुखतालें हांव जायना तशें आनी दोतोरांनी म्हाका वखदां दिलीं तरी म्हाका बरें दिसोंक नासलें. आयज म्हाका झिरो बाबान घरा हाडलें म्हणून हांव पावलीं हांगासर. जेजूक आर्गां दिता ताज्या उद्देशी म्हाका हांगा येयना बारी म्हाका बरें दिसलें तुमच्या मागण्यान ब्रादर जॉन्सनाच्या मागण्यान म्हाका बरें दिसलें जेजूच्या नांवान आर्गां तुका जेजू.
Brother, could you just translate that if you don't mind?
She was very bad.
She was very?
Very sick.
Very sick.
Actually, she used to come very often here. But now for the last 1 month, she was sick, and from her home, she was taken to her daughter's place. And today only I got a message. The daughter told me that she is not well, and she wants that you should come and give her some advice. So I told her, Brother Johnson's retreat is going on. Today is the last day. I will take you there. She was in Aldona. I dropped my people here first, and then I went and I brought her from Aldona. And she said, the moment she came here, we reached a bit late. The prayers were going on, especially the gift of tongues. praying in tongues. And with that, she said, when I started praying and all of you started praying, I felt so much ease that all her limbs, her pains started going out one by one.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you. Thank you so much.
She could not walk. She could not walk. We caught hold of her hand, both sides, and we brought her here. But now, when she came here, after this, she walked her on her own.
Woo, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We give you the glory, Lord. Your name, baby? The last testimony for today.
My name is Marisha Gonsalves, and I'm from Goa. So, when I came here, this all 4 days retreat, first day when I came, I didn't experience much power. I didn't experience something, anointing. I didn't experience nothing. But from the second, third, fourth day, this all 4 days retreat brought me closer to Jesus. And today, when the anointing service gift of tongue, it was going on, I had gift of tongues. But today, I got a new gift of tongues.
Wow, so a new tongue. Hallelujah. Woo. So this is for you, baby, and God bless you, and may the Lord continue to increase in you.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. I'm Lavina from Mangalore, Lavina Rodriguez. We have been connected to this ministry since last 10 years, and we feel like coming back each and every time. We feel so loved, and they are accepting us unconditionally. I'm sure you all are feeling that here. No other ministry have I seen. We have roamed about so many ministries, but nothing like this ministry who activates so much in love. And I want to tell you that I am here to thank God. On my 25th wedding anniversary, I've come here with my children, niece, Tanya and brothers from Mangalore, to thank God for the times that He has been with us through this word of God, through all the storms in our life which came, and we stood firm, and we have been like that rock, the house built on a rock which will never which will never fall. Amen. But will stand firm in all circumstances. So I wish you, brothers and sisters, that every time there's a retreat, and when it's possible, please come back here and attend the retreat. I know that it is there on internet and on radio and on TV, but whatever it is, whenever it is possible, to come and get charged once again and learn new things, because I learned something new. Though I'm coming more than 10 times over here, I have learned about the snare and something new. Each and every time we come, there's something new that we learn over here. And I'm feeling so loud and blessed coming for this retreat. Praise the Lord. And I would like to share a little more. I want to tell you in this, because the youth are here, I would like to share that I'm working for a women's college. I just got a job as a placement officer in Agnes, and I wouldn't get leave. But my principal said, you are going to celebrate your 25th anniversary with Jesus, please go for the retreat. And then I came here, and I want to tell you that my daughter, eldest daughter, I've got three daughters, two are here, one is studying in Australia. And how she got there, it is only because of this word of God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
She went through a short failure in her life in the PUC, but then she regained and she came out so victorious that she was through distinction in her degree, and because of that she got a scholarship to study abroad, overseas scholarship from the government of Karnataka, and now she's studying in Brisbane, Australia. Praise the Lord. And my second daughter, after she was born, we came to know that she was weak on her left side, and her hand grew, though it was a little short, hand grew in one of a retreat like this, where Brother Johnson and Brother Elred were also present at Bangalore, and she's here. And she was slow in her learning, but today I want to tell you, yesterday was the results, and she got a message, she has passed first class with distinction, her BCom. Praise the Lord. And my husband, as a family, we went through financial crisis, and we went through for last 8 years or something, and then we got a breakthrough, but after that again he didn't have a job. And now I want to tell you, yesterday the work has begun, though the project had conceived, like we had got that project and we got the news 1.5 years back. It had not started. There were a lot of hurdles, but actual work on the site has begun yesterday. Praise the Lord.
Yesterday, just yesterday. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So I'm telling, there are so many more things to share, but this is more than enough. And my youngest daughter is also there. She is in the 12th now.
Who is the daughter who had a problem with the hand? And why I asked her to extend her hands was for a reason. Can you just quickly just tell us about that miracle that God moved about with her hand?
Yeah. When she was born, the cord, the umbilical cord was around her, and because of that she suffered a weakness on her left side, like a paralytic patient, her leg too. And she was not walking when she was 1 year, and she used to drag a bum and she used to come behind us wherever we went, and we used to feel so sad. And I used to tell God, I was loving God so much that why did it happen to me, because I'm such a good Catholic. So I used to always think like that, and I used to ask God, question God, why this happened to me? And all the time you're after me only. There are no other people for you to be after. Why are you always chasing after me? But I didn't know that this was for a great testimony. When we went for a retreat, she was around 10 years old, and we as a team from Goa, Bangalore and Mangalore had all met at a fire retreat at Bangalore. And she was sitting with Brother Johnson, and she fell to the ground when the praise and worship adoration was going on. And that was the first time we saw this kind of a thing, and we were all upset the baby fell down. So he said, don't touch the baby. God is operating on her. He is doing anesthesia on her and he is treating her. And she was there, fallen for 2-3 hours. And when she woke up, and they told us, don't open your eyes. And we were lost in the worship, praising God and thanking God and receiving his love. By the time this girl is near the mic, taking the mic and saying, my hand grew, and somebody is lifting her to the mic to give the testimony, and something happened, the hand stretched and she's showing her hand like this together, that it was grown by the power of the Holy Spirit. Just a current flow. And it was weak too. Now it is, we can't even make out that she had a deformity or she was weak. And she was slow in her studies. I used to go and tell her principal that please keep her for 2 years in the KG class so that she will do well later. But she said, don't worry, let her go on normally, then we will see. But I want to tell you, not a single failure till now. Praise the Lord. It's only because of the confessing of the word of God. Mainly the scripture, Luke 4:18-19, brother told you, the spirit of the Lord is upon me, and God himself has anointed me, has set me free from every curse and bondage, and filled me with his love. You have to confess it every day, and confess it for your loved ones also who are not in the Lord, and surely you will be blessed. So I
praise the Lord. Praise, come on, the give Lord. The Lord a big hallelujah. Shout of praise. Come on, hallelujah. So thank you so much, and we praise God that God has given us the secret in Joshua 1:8. Meditate on the word day and night and you will be successful. So confess the word day and night and you will see many miracles working in your life.